Thanks, Mike. And yes, I have a lot of things to get done this weekend. But going back to last weekend, about the only, well, one of the good things about, you know, playing on the road was we were 160 miles away from the weather. So there was very, very misty out there. We had zero wind. So the weather factors did not play anything. But going on the road for the first two weekends is always a challenge with your team. But our team begins to show that signs of maturity and development. And truly believe we took a step in the right direction with that. Our defense, you know, again, jumped right back in. And they ended the first half. They had 19 yards of total offense, okay, which really, really set the stage for us offensively moving forward. And some real good plays from our defensive line, Joey Slackman, Micah Morris, and linebacker Jack Fairman had standout games there. Flipped over the offense, which you really wanted to see them take the next step with some explosive plays. We had 520-plus yards of offense. Quarterback threw, he was 35 for 47 and 350 yards. Threw the ball and just, you know, great distribution with the football. But our three sophomore wide receivers, Jared Richardson, B.C. Owens, and Alec Haight, all collected for 24 catches on the day. So it was really good to see that happen on offense. With that, we also rushed for over 160 yards. So you saw a lot of things where the first week you wanted to improve upon, and we did make that jump forward. A couple glitches and a little bit of our extra point game, which we really need to touch it up on, not think with the protection, only a little bit of personnel that will address that. And our kickoff return becomes a weapon again. Another time we had an explosive kickoff return, brought it over the plus side and turned that into a score. So that part of it's being the gel. Our guys are playing with confidence, which you like to see. But understand those things are done. And now we go into league play against a traditional game against Dartmouth. This is the first time I think we're playing them in the sunlight in a very long time. It's always been a traditional Friday night game. So it would be great not to take that trip up, as they have to take that trip down to us. They're a very good team. They're 1-1, lost to a very good New Hampshire team, beat Lehigh this past weekend. One thing about Dartmouth, they are very, very similar to what they've been for the last decade. Very, very stout defense, very sound football team. They will pressure, but not very much. They want you to make mistakes. And they have a two-quarterback system, which one quarterback does a phenomenal job of running the ball. At some sets, they'll essentially have, you know, 12 personnel with two tight ends that both go 6'4", 275 apiece. So they're going to bring the big boys in. And it's truly single-wing football. Quarterback throws the ball very sparingly there. Then long yard situations and pick up tempo, they'll go to a quarterback who's throwing the ball and spraying the ball out a little bit. So we'll have our hands on defense that way to defend against their wide open approach to it. So our kids are ready. We've had a couple good practices this week, very, very focused, and it's great to have them at home as opposed to going back on the road again. So excited about getting things started.
Does finally an Ivy game, if it give you guys a sense of where you are compared to the rest of the league?
Yeah, again, take scores and teams out of it right now. You saw some things in our league this year, Friday night game with Harvard, close game against Brown, Yale, Cornell. So our league is sort of all over the place. And I'm not sure if anybody truly knows until you get to league play how good you are against other people. I think that's sort of the hardest part of coaches, how good is your team when they face A, B, C, and D. And I think we're still figuring that piece of it out. Now the speed of the game, now we got it. Both teams got to have two games under their belt. And now we'll see how we can separate and how good are good players are, and can we continue to get better? Because I truly believe that we are not, even though we play better, we still have perhaps another level to get to on both sides of the football field, all three facets of it.
Yeah, you've had a couple games now, you've seen them react in game conditions. What have you been most pleased with? What aspect of the game
did your team playing the best? Yeah, I'd say this. I anticipated our defense with the depth, the maturity, all the guys coming back to do what they're doing right now. So Coach Benson and staff have done a great job of continuing with how they ended the season last year. Most pleased with it probably be the offense and how we're coming together with Aiden there, with a group of wide receivers. We're playing six or seven guys in the rotation and how they're really blending together, understanding the offense. And Dan Swanson, our offense coordinator, does a terrific job with that of attacking the weaknesses of teams. So, again, if teams are going to allow us to dink and dunk, we're going to spread the ball out and just move the ball as we can down the field. So we're making those progressions, game by game, and just hope we can take that next step this weekend. Great. Well, thank you very much. Good luck, everybody.
Thanks.